Now, recently I told you there was going to be a state committee hearing in New Jersey to get a resolution through to get call for a convention, to get an amendment, to get money out of politics. Now, this is what we think we should do as a country. We formed Wolfpack, and there are a lot of you out there, in fact, thousands of you across the different states fighting for this. We asked you guys to help fight in New Jersey. You did. Dozens of Wolfpack supporters went to the committee hearing. It was a state, Senate State Government Committee. And first I want to show you what happened at the committee, and then I'll tell you who won, and then I'll tell you the really interesting part about the people who showed up to fight against us. Interesting. All right, first, I want to go to Stephen Garcia. He's been a great Wolfpack volunteer in New Jersey, terrific worker. You got to understand something. Stephen's regular citizen, like all of us. He's got a regular job. He was watching Young Turks, got involved in the Wolfpack. Here he is testifying in front of a committee in New Jersey, and all the politicians are like, oh, this team Stephen Garcia is here. Let's hear him out. Isn't that wonderful? That's how a democracy is supposed to be. Listen to his speech.
Top of that list. We have not sacrificed so much to sit idly by and watch our democracy fade away. This is not what our brothers, sisters, mothers, fathers, and children have died for. You don't have to be a soldier to fight for this country. Everyone in this room has a chance to honor the men and women of our military and anyone who's come before us in the name of keeping America a true democracy by using the privileges they fought so hard to protect. Make no mistake, ladies and gentlemen, there's a battle going on for the soul of this country. It's being attacked by money, but it's attacking Americans. And if there's one thing Americans know how to do, it's to fight for our freedom. This is our moment to show future generations that we didn't turn away from our responsibilities, that we took up the mantle and we fought when people told us it couldn't be done, that the influence of money was too strong. The other day, a friend of mine, Jake Uger, said something that is true, so I have to mention it here. Every generation of Americans has proposed a constitutional amendment except for this one. We're supposed to amend the Constitution because it was designed that way. Amendments to the Constitution are the Bill of Rights. Amendments freed the slaves and gave women the right to vote. And now I can free our country from the oppression of money and politics.
Now, Stephen Garcia, I know because he's a listener of the Young Turks and he joined Wolfpack, right? But I don't know him otherwise. We all meet through this, right? And he's a regular guy, goes in, gives a great speech. By the way, he's absolutely right. People were willing to die for freedom, right? The civil rights movement, freedom riders, they risked their lives. The Klan would show up during their bus trips, right? We can't pick up a phone. We can't go to a committee hearing to get our democracy back. And if they did in New Jersey, and guess what happened? We won. Okay, 3-1 in the committee hearing, we won. So for those of you who are unfamiliar with the process, totally understandable, very complicated at times, right? There's basically three stages, right? You need someone to introduce the resolution, you need it to pass committee, and then it passes the overall Senate and House. So we're just past stage two. It's out of committee, it's gonna go to the Senate, the full Senate, and there we have an excellent chance of winning, okay? Now, it wasn't just Stephen Garcia, it was dozens. We don't have time to show all the videos of all the supporters who came. Chelsea Richardson gave a great speech. Our state leader there is Walker Green, and Eli Fendelman, Mark Danger, et cetera. They all did a great job. And the fight's not over. We gotta go now, take it to the Senate and the House of New Jersey. But here's the interesting part. Guess who showed up to argue against this resolution?
The Koch brothers?
How did you know?
Because okay. It's always them.
Okay, now, wouldn't it be awesome if Charles and David Koch walked in? Right. No, that's not how it works. So their group, Americans for Prosperity, okay? Oh. So they come in and they give a speech saying, oh, no, this is, don't do this. This would be very dangerous to our interests, okay? I bet it would. But here's an interesting twist. They did not show up when the United States Congress was so-called debating an amendment. Because they knew that's just for show. They're not actually going to pass an amendment. We have Congress in our back pocket. For the first time, they show up at the state level there because they say, whoa, this can get done. Mm-hmm. We better start fighting them. Oh, well, Koch brothers, welcome to the ring. Okay? And guess what? On this one, first time you showed up, Wolfpack 1, Koch brothers 0.
So what's the saying, Cenk? First they dismiss you, then they laugh at you, then they fight you, then we win.
That's right. Yeah. So that means we're pretty close.
They're at the point
where they're fighting. That means they view us as a real threat to their ability to buy all the politicians with their money, okay? And they're right, we are a threat to that. We do intend to get it back to free and fair elections where everybody gets one vote. The Charles and David Koch don't get to put in $1 billion and have so much more say in this government than you do. No, Stephen Garcia and Chelsea Richardson and all those guys are going to be the equals of Charles and David Koch if we get our democracy back by getting money out of politics. That's what the Koch brothers can't stand. The idea that you, the unwashed masses, would have the same vote, that you would be equal to them when they have all of this money. They should be able to buy whatever they want with their money, including our government. Well, we're going to put an end to that. So you keep coming, okay? We can't wait to see you at the next committee hearing. We can't wait to see you at the next vote. And we're going to kick your ass from state to state to state.